We had a look at our accounts and...
They're taking you out of school.
We're not taking you out of school, we're transferring you.
It is the feel-good film that has broken Irish box office records. Sing Street takes you back to the decade with the shittest hair, the 80s, in a city with the shittest of weather, Dublin. And in the shittiest of schools, a young band is born, and they are, surprisingly, not shit.
You play every instrument known to mankind.
Probably.
Sure.
Ferdia, Walsh-Peelo and Marc McKenna were plucked from obscurity to start in the movie, and then we plucked them into this hotel room, partially to ask them questions about the movie, but mostly just to marvel at the luscious hair.
We have to talk about the hair, because the 80s was the era of the hair.
We have to talk about the hair.
And neither of you guys are lacking in hair, which is good to see.
Yeah, no.
But have you ever considered going back to the mullet, Marc?
I actually had a mullet when I was like 13. It was pretty terrible. There's probably a picture of it somewhere. I think all my friends...
You can believe we're going to find that picture.
I tried to delete it off everything and all my friends screenshot it so I couldn't get rid of it.
Jesus, what are you all wearing?
Yeah, we're just working that out.
If there's one piece of fashion from the movie that you think is ripe for a return, what do you reckon it is?
Either the blue velvet suit or double denim.
Double denim is sick.
I was going to say the glasses. I feel like the glasses are ready to come back.
We did a scene actually, and since the lens was plastic, like it wasn't real glasses, the sun was going through and it was like a magnifying glass kind of effect. And it started heating up my eye and it started like really stinging and I started like tearing up in the middle of a scene.
This is what Marc says it was, but he was really just getting
I was going to say, this is a great acting tip for somebody. Put magnifying glasses in your eyes.
I was sitting there doing a scene and John was like, Marc, are you crying? And I was like, no.
I'm not crying.
That moment when you step into a cinema and it's packed with people and you know they're about to watch you, 8 feet tall, what goes through your head?
Shit.
Nobody will let us see it before the world premiere in Sundance. And there was literally, you know, 1,500 people in the theatre. That was our first time watching it, and you know, Sting was sitting next to me and everything, and it was like,
I remember for the first half hour of watching it for the first time, I was shaking. Whenever I came up in a scene, say I had like a line that was supposed to be funny, I'd be like, shit, I hope people laugh.
How come you're not in school?
I'm a model.
Cool. Do you want to be in a video for my band?
So if you're in a band, sing me a song.
Take on me.
To learn how to play.
Do the Sex Pistols know how to play? You don't need to know how to play. Who are you, Steely Dan? You need to learn how not to play, Connor. That's the trick. That's rock and roll.
There was a period, though, after you finished filming where you must have gone back to school.
Oh, yeah. That was a bumpy ride back to kind of reality.
It was shit, basically.
It was shit.
I can imagine it was shit, but why was it shit? What was it about it?
I just suddenly, you know, was working every day with adults, and I had an apartment in town. You know, and I was living like the dream, and then I just come back to school and now I'm suddenly in kind of like a crappy building with, you know, teachers telling me what to do, and you kind of have yourself convinced that you are an adult.
Like waking up is hard enough to go to school, but like especially when you've just finished a film, it's extremely hard to go back to school then, because you're just kind of like, this day last week I was on a film set and you're just like, what the hell happened?
Yeah.
I'm convinced that the teachers just kind of, when I came back, they were like, we have to...
Cut them down to size. Yeah.
There's totally
and
that
like,
thing.
Whenever I did anything in class, they'd just be like, Marc, shut up. And I was like, I'd answer a question. They'd be like, Marc, what's the answer to this? I'd answer, be like, Marc, shut up. And I was just like, what?
It's also, I guess, the thing of like, you've gone off and worked on a movie, but the movie hasn't come out yet. So nobody else knows really what you've done yet until it comes out. Do you remember the first time you walked past a poster? Because that's one of those moments where you're like,
that was great, because in Dublin is a little bit of a dream of ours. They're on the Dublin bus, so
I wasn't even on the poster. I was on the poster in England and not Dublin.
Yeah. So you now need to take more trips to London and just wander around going, oh, is that
the
me?
Tube station, I paid to go into the tube station, it's just a stamp side the poster, I don't even go anywhere. Everyone was like, oh man, I saw the poster for your film. You went on it, and I was like, I know.
Your friends could be better. The inference I'm taking between that and the story of
Friday. If any of them see this, we're not hanging out anymore.
Guys, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thanks so much for talking to us. This is the part where I don't know which hand to go with. Let's go with both.
I'll shake this hand too.
Yep, this is great. This is great. This literally couldn't get any weirder. At what point do we stop?
We don't.
Never? Okay.
Just keep going.
Yeah.
That's true.
All right. Yeah.